Hi, I'm Adam Zell, Crush Plant Technical Director for Purdue Agribusiness. I'm here today to tell you a little bit about our Chesapeake, Virginia soybean crush plant, where we process 2,400 tons of soybeans per day.
Chesapeake is one of four solvent extraction plants that we operate at Purdue Agribusiness. I'm going to take you through the entire process at the plant and how we separate out each part of the bean that come into our facility. A soybean is about 20% oil, 5% hulls, and 75% meal, and we produce all three of these products at the crush plant. The process begins at the soybean supply tanks. The beans that come to us have already been graded, cleaned, and dried. Because we're a 24/7 continuous operation, our grain team works hard to keep these supply tanks filled up for us, while also balancing the loading of over 100 vessels per year. From the supply tanks, the beans are conveyed about 500 feet through a series of belts before going into a scale that measures the beans that are processed. The beans then pass through a cleaning aspirator where they are cleaned one final time before beginning the process. Since the beans were already cleaned at grain once, this aspirator typically just removes loose hulls, sticks, and pods. Next, we crack the beans. The plant has four cracking roll machines that each have two sets of corrugated rolls to crack the bean into small pieces. The top set of rolls cuts the bean into halves, and then the second set breaks them into quarters and eighths. This helps separate the hull from the bean. After the cracking mills, the beans and hulls drop into primary aspirators, which are quite different pieces of equipment than the mechanical separation tables we have at our three other crush facilities. The aspirators are designed to separate the beans and hulls by their difference in density, and air is drawn through the material to pull the loose hulls away from the cracked beans. This is a critical part of the quality process, as we don't want to leave too many hulls in the bean stream because that will impact the quality of the finished meal. We also don't want too many beans in the hull stream because then we will lose valuable oil.
The hulls removed from the primary aspirators are conveyed by air to a cyclone. The cracked beans then continue through to secondary aspirators where additional loose hulls are removed from the bean stream and these hulls are conveyed to a second cyclone. The hulls and small amount of cracked beans that may have been drawn with them to the primary and secondary cyclones are then conveyed to a screener to help with separating the hulls and cracks, leaving a stream of just hulls.
The hulls are then conveyed to a hull grinder and ground down to a smaller size. After grinding, the hulls are mixed with some water and steam and sent through a pellet mill to pelletize them to create the first of our three finished products. Soy hull pellets. This is something that is unique about our Chesapeake site in that the hulls are pelletized. At our other three plants, we simply make ground soy hulls. Soy hull pellets are more desirable to the international market and are typically used as a feed ingredient for animals like dairy cows and hogs. Now that the hulls have been removed, we go back to the soybean cracks to further follow them through the process. After de-hulling, the beans are conveyed through a rotary kiln to heat the beans up to prepare them for further processing. Steam tubes and air inside this vessel heat the cracked beans. After they have been heated, the warm cracks are then sent to 9 flaking mills where the beans are turned into thin flakes. The flaking mills use hydraulic pressure on the rolls to flatten the bean pieces into 15/1000ths of an inch flakes, which are optimal for the extraction process. The flakes are then conveyed over to the extraction area and specifically to the heartbeat of a crush plant, the extractor. The design of this extractor is quite different than our other three extraction plants. This extractor, which was just installed in October of 2023, is an environmentally friendly design that will improve quality and allow for future plant throughput growth. The flakes drop into the extractor and are then conveyed through it using a large chain and paddles. The flakes ride on stainless steel screens where they're constantly being washed with a hydrocarbon solvent called hexane, which has a high affinity to extracting soybean oil. If we then follow the liquid stream out of the extractor, we now have a mixture of approximately 25% soybean oil and 75% hexane. This liquid then passes through a series of evaporators operating under high mercury vacuum to remove the hexane from the oil. The hexane vapor is condensed and reused in the process and the oil that comes out of the end of the process is the second of our finished products, crude soybean oil. The soybean oil produced at the Chesapeake site can either be exported or can be sent to our edible oil refinery in Salisbury, Maryland, to be processed into food-grade vegetable oil. The other stream that leaves the extractor is the solid flake stream that has now had the majority of the oil extracted from them. These flakes that leave the extractor are about 30% by weight hexane. The flakes are conveyed to the desolventizer toaster, or DT, where they pass through 9 steam-heated trays and are introduced to live steam to strip the hexane out of the meal. The hexane evaporator from the meal is condensed and recovered, along with the hexane removed from the oil, and is reused. Because the meal is subjected to live steam in the DT, it leaves that vessel at approximately 18% moisture, so it must be dried and cooled prior to sending it to storage. The meal is conveyed from the DT to a dryer cooler, where air passes through steam coils to dry the meal down to the desired finished moisture of about 12.5%. The meal then leaves the dryer cooler and is conveyed back to the prep building where the process all began. The meal is then ground to its desirable size. The meal leaving the grinders is our third and final product. Soybean meal is used as a high protein ingredient in poultry feed. From the meal grinders, the meal is either conveyed to a couple of storage tanks or to flat storage buildings. Because the Chesapeake site loads vessels, there's over 30,000 tons of meal storage on site. The meal is loaded out of the tanks into smaller volume 25-ton containers, or is loaded from the flat storage buildings onto bulk vessel shipments. And that's the process. Whole soybeans into the plant are converted into 3 valuable products and shipped all over the world.